Sherrod Bascaran has worked for 7 years here at Astrobotic as the mission director for Peregrine, and he tells me it was so satisfying to see that launch and then the anomaly, which meant they would not make it to the moon. And then he says here inside mission control, everything changed.
Well, first of all, it's difficult to get to the moon, and so we've faced a lot of challenges developing the spacecraft, developing the mission overall. But then when you're faced with the real-time challenge of trying to recover from an anomaly in space, that's a whole different set of challenges, and the team responded tremendously to that kind of pressure.
Standing feet from mission control, Bascaran told me about the adjustments they made in space from their north side headquarters, working first to keep Peregrine's batteries charged, then to gather data, and ultimately making the decision to let the lander no longer able to make a soft landing on the moon re-enter the atmosphere and burn up over the Pacific Ocean. Bascaran tells me it's tough to make those calls, and while they will go over the mission with a review board, here in Pittsburgh, they are focusing on what's next.
Griffin is, as you can see behind me, is in early stages of build, and so we've got a long way ahead of us because there's a lot of work to build this to a full spacecraft, like you saw with Peregrine, but we're making good progress, and we're excited about the next opportunity to land a spacecraft on the moon.
And Bascaran tells me here inside Astrobotic, they are expecting to do that by the end of the year. Outside Astrobotic on the north side, Marcy Cipriani, Pittsburgh's Action News 4.